Hey guys, ScannerDanner here. I am with a friend of mine today. It is Tommy Wolf of Positive Lead Diagnostics. That is his YouTube channel name, and I will put information for his channel so you can look him up in the description of this video, as well as maybe some links at the end that you guys can click on and go right to his channel. He is my Volkswagen expert. He's actually a former student of mine. How many years you in the field now?
It's eight.
Eight years. So 8 years, he's a Volkswagen Master Tech, ASE Certified Master Tech. You guys that follow me on Facebook would know about him. You guys need to look us both up on Facebook. ScannerDanner, I have a channel page, and he has Positive Lead Diagnostics channel page. Make sure you guys go there and like our pages, and then you'll be able to follow what we're doing a lot better. But a lot of you guys have been asking for more European cars from me. I don't work on very many of them, and we have an opportunity here to work with a Volkswagen Master Tech. Today we're working on a 2012 Volkswagen Jetta that has a no-com issue, right? And we don't have to go through all the details right now, but we have a no-com with the TCM. It won't come out of park, low power. I do okay on that?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's what we're doing. Looking at this car, and then hopefully I'll be able to have a chance to show you guys a new tool that I purchased, which is called a HEX-NET by Rosedale. Rosedale is who makes this tool, and I purchased this tool in light of an Audi S4 that my class and I really got our asses kicked by. It was a GDI system where the high pressure pumps were not being activated from a faulty engine mount solenoid. So if you guys are interested in that series, great series, it's on ScannerDanner Premium. I'll put the links to that series in the description of this video as well. Anything else we want to add before we jump on this car?
I don't think so.
Okay, so me and Tommy Wolf, we're going to troubleshoot this car together, and I hope you guys enjoy it. Guys, as we're discussing where are we starting, where are we putting the camera so you guys can see, I said to Tom, I said, let's hook your VagCom up and compare it, and he doesn't even have one. Wait, you work at a Volkswagen.
It's not cool, I am.
How do you not have a VagCom and you work at a Volkswagen dealer?
I haven't needed one.
Well, doesn't the dealership itself have one for you to use?
No. We have the factory scan tool.
Okay, wait. The factory scan tool is not a VagCom?
It's not a VagCom.
So what's the factory scan tool?
It's called Otis.
Otis.
Yeah.
So I thought that the VagCom was a factory tool.
It is not.
It is not.
It's aftermarket.
Really? Look, see, learn something new every day. So it's called a what again?
The factory?
Yeah.
It's called Otis.
Otis.
Yeah.
Like, isn't that like something?
Like off
Otis.
Forward.
Wasn't that like Milo and Otis? Wasn't that like some kind of dog
like
and cat show?
Or some stellar.
Otis. So do we compare it to the Otis? I don't think we do.
No, the format
so
is
who
totally
makes
different.
So who makes the VagCom?
Rosedale.
Rosedale makes the VagCom.
Yes.
So this, I have a VagCom.
Yes.
This HEX-NET. It's called a HEX-NET.
I need to see it, but
it says HEX-NET by Rosedale.
I'm almost 100% it's a VagCom.
Okay. Well, I don't know if we want to start there. Let's not start with that tool. I want to start with what you saw. Show us what you found. Let's go there. Okay.
Yeah. That's fine.
So check this out. You can see that Tommy was one of my students. Look at his multimeter. You guys know that multimeter. Hold that up. Look, it's my ideal meter that I have at school. This was in your kit.
This meter is ideal.
Yeah. Anyway, we're not plugging that tool. I just think it's funny that Tommy has the same multimeter as me. So we're starting this diagnosis using the VERUS. Now, this feels weird to me. We're at a Volkswagen dealership, but we're troubleshooting this 2012 Volkswagen with the VERUS. All right, Tommy. So tell me what the customer's complaint was on this car.
All right.
What are we doing?
Okay. The vehicle was towed in. Customer complaint is that it won't come out of park. Check engine light and EPC light are on. So the main complaint is that it wouldn't come out of park.
Okay.
I had to manually put it into drive with the shift interlock, and doing that, there is no power.
Is there a manual bypass for the interlock?
Right, right.
Okay.
So you have to lift the center console trim. Basically the plastic covering over the center console, and there is a yellow tab. You literally just push down on it and you can move it into gear.
Okay.
I had to do that, and there is no power. I could full throttle this thing. It doesn't get out of its own way. So EPC light being on,
Check engine light on too?
Check engine light, EPC light.
Gotcha, okay. So then we just did an all code scan. Do we have that option on the VERUS?
Yes, we do.
Okay, so is that where you started or?
Yeah, I mean, that was basically all I did was scan for trouble codes first.
Okay, and so. I guess we can tell them what you found. So go ahead.
So scanning the vehicle, the first trouble code, or mainly the only trouble code that I have is TCM No Communication. I'm not sure the P code or U code. Okay. I think it's a U code. Okay. So
TCM No Com, and,
yes.
And this is where we are with this vehicle, and you know, what do we need to do to figure it out? That's what we're doing in the video. Yes? Yep,
that's it.
And we're using a VERUS on a...
You gotta love it.
On a Volkswagen. My Volkswagen MasterTech friend, who does not even have a VAGCOM. And I've been misquoting the VAGCOM as the factory tool. Again, it's called an Otis. How long has it been an Otis?
Not too long. It's been a couple years.
What was the model before the Otis?
It's called VAS PC.
VAS PC.
Yes.
So there's my uneducated comments for years about the VAGCOM. I've been calling it a VAG tester forever.
VAG. Yeah. I never say VAG. VAG. VAG.
But it just made me mad. These European cars piss me off because I never have the information I need. And you know from helping me on that Audi series.
Dude, I know from working here.
That car, I got in trouble from bad data. Not bad data, just I misinterpreted the data I was looking at because of the information.
But the information wasn't there.
Information wasn't there. Okay, good. So this is what we're dealing with. Yeah, no communication with transmission control module U0101. Okay, cool.
That's pretty much it.
All right, so what was your next step?
Basically,
all the other modules we were able to communicate with, yes?
Yeah, all the other modules.
Do you want to show us the all code scan?
Let's do that.
Yeah. Hey, wait, before you begin talking to that. I don't know that this tool is going to, well, it will help us for what we're doing. I have a tool I wanted to introduce, and I have another video where I've shown this, but this is actually it's called a LineSPI. It's by AES. And what this tool is going to allow us to do, given we have a NOCOM, is we'll plug into the data link connector here, and our scan tool will connect here, so we can have the scan tool connected, and we can communicate, and we can monitor our CAN lines on our on this board. Basically, this is your 16-pin data link connector, and it has some LEDs and stuff for troubleshooting. But I think this will help us connect our scope while we have the scan tool on. We're gonna put this on too. All right, we're all hooked up.
Everyone's, you know, since I don't have a VAGCOM, dude, expert mode, it's pretty much the same thing. But when you go in there, you need to know what you're looking for. That's the only difference.
What we learned the hard way on that Audi series.
Yeah, so if you don't have that information, then you're not gonna know what to go to.
So you're just going vehicle selection, not expert mode.
Correct, yeah.
Wait, I want to see that VIN for a second. Just make sure that you all see what we're working on here. Okay. Is this a GDI engine, Tom?
This is not.
Okay.
Not a GDI. So,
okay, so we have code scan, which scans all the modules on this car.
Yes.
All right, what are these, the way that they have these numbers here for these Euro cars, what are the numbers next to the module?
That's just the address word identifier.
That's what they call it.
Yeah, that's pretty much, it's just address word.
Okay.
That's,
okay.
You know?
Yeah.
I think Volkswagen, you know, they, instead of saying, I don't know, engine or ECM, they'll say, you know, address word 01, I think J220 or something. J220 would be the DIN identifier for ECM. I mean, they have different ones, but.
Okay.
That's just the address word. We can do code scan for this one.
Yeah. So this will be cool because it'll tell us how many systems we have on the car too, right? How many modules are talking on this particular network? Yes?
I don't know if it'll be network specific, but it'll be all the modules pretty much. You know what I mean?
Well, there would be modules maybe that wouldn't be on this particular line possibly. Is that, that's what you're... I mean, it should be all the modules that are on the CAN network.
Yeah, in the car,
on
yes.
On the CAN, okay.
Yes.
That's what I meant. Like, what we see here, like it says systems detected one, we're still waiting.
Yeah.
Which is
right? Or is it still?
Right, right now it's trying to find the transmission and gotcha. It can't.
It can.
So. Yeah, I thought you meant like if we were looking at the K line, like underneath management, it would just be ECM, TCM. You know what I mean? And then go to convenience can. It's not like
what's,
that.
What's the K line?
Yeah, the reason I asked what's the K line is you see it says for pin 7, it says ISO, KWP, and then it says K. Would that be what you're talking about?
Possibly.
And then ISO, KWP 15 is L. Network stuff that we're all going to learn how to use this tool better here soon.
Okay, talk to me, Tommy. What do we have? How all many right. modules we have on this system?
So, according to this, we have 13 systems detected.
Okay.
Right here. And then it just gives you a list of what the scan tool was talking to. Tells you how many codes are in each module.
There's 11 codes in the CEM. But the central electronic unit, yeah. Sorry, CE, I don't know what you call it. I had a Volvo, it was called a CEM, so sorry.
That would just be the BCM on this.
Okay.
And then if we just scroll down, it's just going to give us a list of each module and what code was in it.
Okay.
I guess
those 13 modules that are detected, that is not including the TCM that we're not talking to.
Right, right.
Okay.
So, or any other module that right, wouldn't exactly, be talking to. Right. But this is just going to give us all the fault codes in each module.
Yeah, tire pressure. So we have a fault code for the brake module, which also is saying, hey, I can't talk to the TCM either. Okay, keep going.
Yeah. Airco. I'm not sure what Airco is, honestly.
Missing message. Probably related.
Yep.
This is the one with 11 faults.
Yeah, this would be the
central
BCM.
Central locking, thermal, what's that? Head, rear window, okay, transmission. So there you go again, TCM not talking on that module either.
Yeah, climatronic, there's a bunch of different ones
ECU
in there.
Driver, what? No signal communication, ECU.
Driver's door.
Dude, you could spend a long time researching some of this stuff. This is a good example of a vehicle that's not in here to fix everything.
Right.
We're here to fix the vehicle, not coming out of park. Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, go ahead. Keep going. Parking lights, horn, supply, terminal 30. Okay, keep going. What's this one? Steering wheel, data bus, missing message. So again, probably related.
Yeah.
Instrument panel, not talking to the TCM. Keep going. TCM again, that's in what? Diagnostic data.
Yeah, so this
interface.
Is the gateway.
Gateway, gotcha.
Yeah. So this is the module that talks to everything, the main brain of the network system.
Do you have that diagram pulled up, Tommy, that shows the gateway?
I have
the network diagram.
I don't have the network diagram. We can get it.
We might. Not yet.
Okay. The diagram I do have is just the TCM.
We're going to be talking about this gateway as we go here, so... But that's the guy that's really responsible for communicating with us right now too, and really is in charge of like all the distribution of signals, if you could say that, through the network.
Yeah, so I'm pretty sure that everything, like when the ECM wants to talk to the TCM, it goes through the gateway. I don't think they're wired.
And we would know by looking
directly
by looking at a diagram.
Correct.
For sure. Yep.
More no communication faults, the main one,
mm-hmm.
TCM.
Mm-hmm.
And then this would be some door modules. All these function limitation due to missing message.
It's all going to be related.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Warning lamp, read trouble codes. And then...
Undocumented.
Yeah.
That's fine. Scroll up. Is that the end of it?
Yep.
Okay. So, no comm, obviously, with the TCM, our focus is on the TCM. That's where you are.
Correct.
Okay. So, what did you do? What'd you do next, Tommy? What was your next
thing? Well, first thing, I needed to find out where it lived. And it lives...
in hell.
Yes.
Well, just tell me now. We'll move the camera in a second. It lives... I saw you had the inner fender out.
Yeah. So, it's up behind the driver's fender.
When you contacted me, you... sent me some snapshots of the CAN lines. When did you access those? You accessed the module next, that's where you went next, before you looked at the CAN network that you were looking at directly at the module, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so that's what I want to see. I want you to show me what you did we'll look at the waveforms on the screen. That's where we'll go next. Yes, that's what you did?
Yeah, I mean. Okay.
Then let's do it. I want you to show us what you did when you snapped those pictures.
Gotcha. Okay.
This guy.
And this was the diagram for what?
This is if you go under transmission.
Okay, so you lied to me. That wasn't your next step.
My next step was exposing the module.
Your next step was pulling that diagram, yes? No? Expose the module first?
It's finding that, because if I pull the module out and there's green crusties all over it, I'm not going any further.
Okay, gotcha. All right, hold on. Let's repeat that. Here, bring that over here.
This?
Yes. So your next step then, Tommy, was to access the module and really look for green corrosion given where it's located, which is in the inner fender of this car. Can you hold that module up for me? Okay, cool. So that lives, to get in there, you just unbolted the inner fender a couple bolts, or do you have the tire off to get in there?
No, I did jack it up just to make it a little bit easier.
Yeah.
But a couple of screws.
Okay, and then you look for green corrosion and...
Yeah, just given its location, like, who puts a module behind a fender liner? So I just wanted to make sure it wasn't something stupid like that, yep. You know?
Okay. And I see you have some terminals back probe, so obviously you then pulled a wiring diagram. You got a pocket screwdriver on, you want to point at this for me?
Okay, so my next step was to flip this. Because right here is my J533 is my gateway. So if you flip this over, you see these are my CAN lines. This would be my TCM, as I say, J217. And right here, these two pins would be my CAN lines, and that's where I'm back probed right now. Pin 46 is my CAN high, and pin 34 is my CAN low.
So wait, I'm a little confused myself here. Hold on. So this is totally different than what I'm used to looking at. So we have these codes on the right-hand side. They have these coded, and I don't have my glasses on, but it says, like, what's that say right there? J?
The J533.
And then what? You could come over on the right column to look that up? See, I don't even. Okay, right there. Data bus onboard diagnostic interface.
So those would be your DIN identifiers. That's what they're known
that's
as.
What
in the German world, I suppose.
That's what they call that number, is a DIN identifier.
Yeah, so... You know, if someone was like, hey, you know, I need a... If you talk to any Volkswagen guy, they're going to be like, I need a J220. And that would be like an ECM. J533 is always the gateway.
So my question looking at this, Tommy, because I'm not used to looking at this style of diagram. You see this is my gateway, you said?
Correct.
Okay, so you see the splice here, and then where does it go? It looks like it goes somewhere else. You said flip the page, right? So these two would be these two.
Correct.
And then you see another splice. It almost like tells you that there's other stuff.
Correct.
On this line. And is this my CAN lines? Yeah, it says CAN positive.
CAN high,
says CAN high, and CAN low. Okay, so that is the CAN network lines. So basically, I bet you if we pulled, does Volkswagen have diagrams that show you the whole network, like on one page, like Mitchell does?
Maybe.
Okay.
It should.
Because maybe what we can do is pull a Mitchell diagram too, because I have my laptop here and we can jump on and see. But anyway, so you use this, and this is a piece of my TCM. You are back probing. What are those two pins, Tommy? I don't have my glasses.
46. Which is this one, that is CAN high, and then 34 is CAN low.
Okay, cool.
So that's where I'm at.
Right at the TCM itself, okay. Then let's see the images you have, or do you want to show us live?
Do you want to do it?
Let's do it live, yeah.
I'll plug this back in, so.
Okay.
You can see what. And to access these pins, there's obviously a plastic cover that goes.
You know what's crazy is when you plug that in, this light lit the K-line. Does that would that make sense at all, that light would light? Why would the K-line?
I'm pretty sure K-line is powertrain, and it's just the ECM, just the TCM on the powertrain line.
The K-line is.
Yeah, that's considered.
I just made an observation. I want to show something here. Again, I'm learning this tool, guys, so you'll have to forgive me for not knowing all the ins and outs of this tool yet. When Tommy plugged that TCM in, this K line
LED. This one right here. Can we see that? Yeah. This LED lit. Go ahead and unplug that again. Watch this. See that light go out? Okay, plug it back in. Just an observation.
Yeah.
So, and you said that you're pretty sure the K line is just the engine and transmission.
I want to say it's for diagnostics. Maybe.
Or is it diagnostics? Is it also maybe a redundant thing for safety in case the CAN network goes down and it maybe can limp home using the K line communications?
No, that's absolutely possible.
Okay. All right, so we did have the key on, by the way, when we were unplugging and plugging in that module, but whatever. We're pretty sure we have a bad TCM anyway. Things that we're not supposed to do, go to school and they tell you never, they tell you to disconnect the battery when you're doing CAN network troubleshooting. I don't think so.
I disagree.
I do too. But we've known that for years. All right, so hook up your VERUS to this thing. Let's take a look at it. We'll get you set up there, or that works down there.
You want it down?
Yep.
Okay, Tommy. What are my scales here that we're looking at?
Okay.
What's your voltage scale set at right now?
All right. Right now, I am on 5-volt scales for both channels.
Yeah.
Channel one, I believe, is on my CAN high.
Okay.
And channel two is on my CAN low. And I'm on 100, what is that, microseconds? This basically the smallest.
Right, and you can't peak detect on those low scales.
No, I couldn't.
My preference on this, Tommy, just because I can see on the yellow trace that I'm missing the tops of that, set both of those to 10 volts.
10 volts?
Yeah. Cool. And then separate those lines a little bit from each other. So they're not.
Damn touchscreen.
Yeah, I know. All right, cool.
Is that good?
Yeah, and then set a trigger on either one, either the yellow or green. That'll keep it from walking on us. We'll be able to see the signals more consistently.
Damn it.
I know.
I'm gonna move it over, is that good?
No, that's cool.
Okay.
And then, hit the fingerprint button to give me more screen view. Perfect. Okay, so that is definitely a goofy looking CAN signal. Let me do something here, Tommy. I'm curious myself. I just been viewing these, actually, believe it or not, the last couple of days. I have this Ford Taurus that I'm messing around with. It's really being I'm trying to duplicate a fault and I'm having trouble. But one of the things that we want to see for sure when we're looking at these is we want to see mirror images of each other. This is one of the main things that we're taught in CAN classes, is these should exactly mirror each other. And you can definitely see that they don't look like a mirror. I mean, you see the frequencies look the same.
Sure, yeah.
You know, the pulse widths and frequencies, but there is a clear difference in the way that these signals look. For you guys that are new at looking at CAN signals, the end of a packet of information, it's normal to have these higher spikes. So that's not an issue, but what is abnormal is how much different these look. Compared to each other. Like you look at the rounded edge here and this one, I don't know if I'd call that a mirror, you know?
It kind of looks like the tops would fill in the gap. It's just strange. Yeah.
So would we call this a mirror image is the question. And you said the other thing too would be our min-max scales. You had mentioned this to me, Tom, that the what we should see is one of them should be going from 2.5 to 3.5. That'd be my CAN high. And then the other one is going from 2.5 to 1, right? Or two, sorry, did I say that right? It's 2.5 to 3.5 on the one line, and it should be 2.5 to 1.5 on the other line.
Yeah.
Right?
I'm pretty sure.
I'm pretty sure too.
Yeah.
So I guess this is where the Pico is real nice with the vertical cursors.
Yeah.
You know, Snap-on, come on, guys, get with the program. Get some vertical cursors in on this thing. Yeah, maybe we do want to hook up the Pico and look at this. But anyway, you showed me these images, and then
my next thought was, I want to figure out what is this signal? Not necessarily what it means, but what is sending it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, if I don't have any communication with this TCM, why don't I just unplug it and see if I have that same signal there?
Okay, I like that approach. So go ahead and.
Let me turn my key off.
Well, did you turn your key off the last 10 times you did this?
No.
Okay, then don't.
All right.
You guys may not like what we're doing, but that's okay.
All right, so. TCM is unplugged.
Yes.
And then I gotta hold these in.
Yeah. And that looks more like what we'd want to see on a CAN network. Like, see how much cleaner those signals are, and you see how very much mirror image they are. So let's freeze that and move down. Like that, those are mirror images of each other. Clear signals. That looks a little bit higher than 3.5 volts on the top of that. We could throw in a cursor and measure that. So we'll just use cursor one. Let's get a top measurement on that. Cursor one, what's the voltage at the top? Is three, what's that say? 3.6 volts at the top. This is the yellow trace. And then
should be 2.5.
2.51 at the valley. So I'm right there. And then the top of the green is 2.45. And the bottom of the green is 1.38. So just to give you guys numbers, but that is clearly a much cleaner signal. All right, so we're basically using that to say faulty TCM, but one of the questions I asked Tom off camera was, what about powers and grounds to the TCM? Like, how do we address that? There's one other thing that we can do too, maybe, on this, Tommy, which is to measure our CAN network resistors, which is part of this too. We may be able to condemn that TCM based on the resistance too of the network. So plug that back in. I want to see that plugged in again. Totally different looking signal.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Right. All right, so before we, and you did check powers and grounds, yes?
I did, yeah.
And we don't need to show that, we can just talk about it. If you guys want help on checking powers and grounds, both Tom and I have many videos where we're checking powers and grounds. That's not the point of this. I'm gonna take your word for it, Tommy. Our TCM has, what, you said one power feed and two main grounds?
Yes.
Okay, and they're good.
Yeah, they were good.
So what's the next step other than putting a TCM in this? It doesn't talk. The network lines are there. It looks clean unplugged, which tells you the rest of the network should be good. Right? We're saying TCM. Put a TCM in.
Yeah.
I mean, but we're both uncomfortable with it in a way, yes? Because it's always hard to call a bad mod.
Yeah.
Always hard. So just letting our subscribers know that, you know, those messed up signals, that's what we're using to call a TCM. And I'm talking to you guys and I'm talking to Tommy and I'm like, is that enough, right? If this is me and I'm at a garage and I don't know Volkswagens very well, a 2012 Volkswagen that needs a TCM, that's not gonna be cheap.
I don't think so.
What, you have a ballpark number?
I can't even
call a thousand.
I don't know if it's 1,000, but it's.
And then you're gonna need
probably at least a couple hundred bucks.
You're gonna need to program that too.
Yes.
A couple hundred's okay.
Yeah, but
I mean, I've seen
maybe 500, you know, that gets a little excessive for you to be like, I think it could be this.
Yeah, for sure. I agree with you.
So,
yeah. Is there anything else we can do, you and I can do, that we can say, hey, this is my issue? I don't know of any other test. This would be where, would you agree that this is where a flowchart would come in?
Yes.
Maybe. But do we... we're at Volt. Yeah. We're dealing with the European market. Talk a little bit about the lack of information. We are at a Volkswagen dealership, and you hear the same stuff from Tom that you hear from me. I'm always whining about information on Volkswagen. So talk about it.
It's the same thing for anyone out there that says, oh, well, you can only get that information at the dealer. That is untrue.
Many cases where there's just not information. When you want to test something and you're like, wow, what should this look like? Guess what? It's not there. So even guys from Audi, you know, when we were trying to get information on that Audi and I was talking to those guys, I'm like, did you ever look at one of the, oh, I don't know. You know, it's the same thing.
That's crazy.
So do we have a flow chart would be the first question that is a no communication to the TCM?
There is.
There is a specific flow chart.
Yes.
Can we look at that and just make sure we didn't miss anything?
We can.
One of the things I want to try before we go to the flow chart is let's do a resistance measurement on this network. We clearly could see the can lines being affected by the TCM. Unplug, plug it in. I mean, it's really distorted. In the network, they use two 120 ohm resistors that are in parallel to each other. So I'm going to put Tommy on the spot here. We'll see how good his knowledge is.
No mathematician.
I had Tommy in class 8 years ago for basic electricity, and we talked about parallel circuits and all of that. And so if we have two 120 ohm resistors in parallel, so next to each other, two different paths, what's my total circuit resistance? It's an easy one.
Ohm's law, dude.
Come on.
I don't even remember the yes, Ohm's you do. Law.
120, 120 in parallel. Remember, parallel circuits, we always lower resistance when we put resistors in parallel. And when we put them in series, we add them together. So in our case.
I knew the series would be total.
In our case, it is, come on, just say the number. You know it.
It'd be 60.
60 ohms. Good job. All right, so 60 ohms is what our network should read. Part of our CAN network diagnostics is to measure the resistance of the circuit. Now, what I can't share with you guys, and these are questions that I asked some instructors recently at a class I was at, which is what's supplying the 2.5 volt bias lines? What's the main module that it's coming from? Which ones are pulling it up? Which ones are pulling it down? Stuff I want to know. I don't have it yet. As we work more and more on these systems, we'll be able to fill in the gaps. Another gap for me is, what are these resistors actually doing? They call them termination resistors. They're part of the network and allows communication to take place. That's all I got.
What does it mean?
What does it mean? What does it do? It's part of our network diagnosis that we may be able to see a resistance change with that TCM being unplugged, if it's pulling that circuit down. But there's a problem, these resistors and their location. I don't know that we have that information. I tried to get a universal piece of information. Is it in the gateway? You know, maybe the resistor's in the gateway, maybe the resistor's in the PCM, maybe the resistor's in the TCM. Some of them, the resistors aren't in any of the modules. They're taped into the network somewhere. They have these
into the wiring.
They have these termination resistors. So, I'm sorry guys, that's where we're at, but I want to try it. We're going to do a quick resistance measurement of the network and then unplug and plug in the TCM. This will be key off. This is going to be with an ohm meter, and then we'll do the flow chart and try to make a final call. Cool?
Good.
Okay. First thing we want to do, guys, when we do this network, is we want to make sure.
I'm going to hold that lead in. Are you looking at this?
Yeah. We want to make sure that our voltage is gone on the network. Now, the guys in the classes I was in recently mentioned disconnecting the battery, and I just don't think that that's necessary. We just want to make sure that there's no voltage. You see, we have 1.5 volts on both circuits right now. So we want to wait. Obviously, we do a resistance measurement when there's voltage on the circuit. We're going to get some goofy number.
Right.
So we'll wait for those to power down. Is that 0.8 and 0.7 right now?
Mm-hmm.
We may have to disconnect the battery. We'll see what kind of numbers we get. I didn't expect to see voltage hanging that high, over 0.5 volts. This is where this tool is going to be of some value to us. And again, you guys are going to have to forgive me for my lack of knowledge of this tool. Maybe, you know what? I still have. Let me pull this key out.
That's probably what it is, man.
No, I'm still at 0.8. Oh, there we go. We're at zero now.
Okay, so we just pulled the key out. Those voltages did drop to zero. And I'm pretty sure that we want to go between the can, between the can negative and the can positive, which would be right here on this. And I don't know, wait, before you do this, there are some isolation circuits, like the way this tool is designed, that I can turn these LEDs off and get them out of the picture, out of the equation. I think that's what we want to do when we do this resistance measurement. We'll kind of experiment with it, and I apologize that I didn't read this owner's manual. I did read it, but I didn't read it. I need to read it multiple times is what I'm telling you. Maybe I'll turn them off. We'll see what kind of signal we get. So between can positive, can negative, go ahead and hook those in there. You got it? And then on our own meter, we have 66.8 ohms. And this is with the TCM plugged in.
Yes.
And the only issue for me is I haven't done very much CAN network resistance measurements to say, hey, that should be 60 ohms. We're at 66. Let's see what it looks like with these other switches being on. I don't know that it matters. 67.5. Again, I'll get more up to speed with this tool later as far as when we want to isolate these. I remember reading it, but I forget. Right now, it's not important. While I'm here, Tommy, go ahead and disconnect that TCM.
Dude, this connector doesn't get any easier. It is out.
So it didn't change at all. We stayed at 66.8. One more thing is take the leads, those back probing leads, out of there. Just to see if there's any change, because we could be, you know, reading into the VERUS. No, 66.8. And plug that TCM back in again, Tom. See, I was hoping, Tom, that this would give us another test for this particular car in making this easier to call. You know?
Yeah, I was hoping to see a change.
Faulty. I would like to have seen a change. I would have liked to have seen that go to like 40 plugged in and 60 unplugged. We could have been like, that's it for sure. But that is your resistance measurement of the CAN network. This is part of every CAN diagnostic NOCOM, I think it should be, is measuring those resistors. Let's turn this back on. Okay, another test I want to try, Tom, is I want to measure the CAN network up here like you were doing down there with your VERUS. So let's get the key back in. Let's get your VERUS up here. You following? You with me?
Yeah, so
I just want to see what it looks like at the data link connector itself.
You. Yeah.
I wonder if I can just use one of these grounds through here.
You can. That's what's nice about the tool.
It is.
You got a chassis ground, you got a signal ground right there. So if your signal's noisy, you know, you can go, you know, right to that, change it up from chassis ground to a sensor ground, you know? 14. So we're using chassis ground for the black lead, and the CAN positive is yellow and CAN negative is green. All right, I got the key on right now. And we have nothing. Why? Are we frozen? Is that frozen?
No.
Is that live?
That is live. 2.5 volts.
So why do I have no signals going on right now? I definitely have the key on. Yes? Key is on?
Yeah, key's on.
We got 2.5 volt flat line. Where's my signal? Where's my signal, Tommy? Let's talk to something.
I was at least expecting like scan tool.
Well, yeah, you will. I know what's going on here.
I do a code scan. It's doing a code scan now. So while it's doing a code scan, we're...
Oh, there was a little... There you go.
Yeah, but that's not what we expect to see. What are we doing wrong, Tommy? We're doing something wrong.
Maybe this ground?
I don't think so. Mm-mm. Let's drop this back. You were on 50 microseconds?
I was on 100.
There we go.
What happened?
Mm-hmm.
What module was it scanning?
I don't know. That's weird. And then look how clean it looks too. Why would it look so crappy at the TCM? And where's all my signals at, dude? Again, they disappeared. What are we doing wrong? We were definitely on the CAN network.
Yeah.
It should be the same down there that it is up here. Unless that, you know, we're looking at, I'm confused.
This is the data link going to the gateway, and that's just the TCM going to the gateway.
But it's on the same CAN network. Let's pull up the diagram.
Why is there this blob on your computer screen, Tommy? What is that?
Someone broke my screen.
Okay, great.
I don't know.
All right. Okay, so what are we looking at? This is our CAN network. So where's the TCM on that?
The TCM.
I want a complete view, like Mitchell gives us.
TCM. J217. Look, this is all it gives me right here. There might be more. That is J217 right there.
What shows J217?
That is our transmission control module.
And those are the ones we were...
All right, so right here, see these wiring colors are different. This is a gray with white TCM, and then 743, which is the mechatronics, which I don't think we don't have that. And then ECM, and that, see this gray and white wire?
Yes.
And this splice, A76 down here says KS diagnostic lead connection. So that would be our K line.
But we weren't connected to that.
No.
We were connected to the CAN lines.
Right.
Where's your CAN lines on?
So we'll scroll down here.
When we were down at the TCM directly, we were on the CAN lines. That was the diagram you showed me.
Yeah. All right, let me find it on here, because it's... obviously a separate one. Look at look how screwed up this diagram is.
Oh, I know, man. I feel bad for you.
Think about it. All the faults that we had.
Right.
They're all on
the same network.
Okay.
So the same thing we saw at the TCM is what we should be seeing up at the...
Should be.
See, this is where knowing which one's doing what. You know what I'm saying? Like, is it possible to have a high resistance connection down at the, in the wiring to the TCM that is messing up our crap?
Dude, I think we're on the wrong lines.
6 and 14?
Yeah.
For this car?
Yeah.
It might not be the CAN network?
No, they are, but it might be a different one. On here, I'm looking at pin 6 and 16.
This is so much better.
I know, tell
this
me about
is
it.
So much better of a diagram.
I hate these diagrams.
We're debating on factory diagram,
yeah.
Mitchell diagram. We're trying to figure out what's what on the network. And I mean, this is night and day different as far as like, you know, this would be better being printed out though too. Yeah, pins 6 and 14 go to my data bus on, that might be why, Tommy. Pin 6 and 14 go right to the data bus onboard diagnostic interface. That's my gateway.
Correct.
So we're between the data link connector and the gateway. That's why we're not seeing anything, because the only time you'd have messages there are when the gateway is talking to the
Scantle.
Yeah. Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
That's why. That's why.
Yeah.
That's what you needed to know right there. The pin 6 and 4, right? Pin 6 and pin 14.
Yeah.
That's why. That's why.
Well, that makes sense.
You know, and this just has to do with not knowing enough about the network and what's doing what at what point in time. I think that's the only explanation for that.
No, I agree.
So then what we need to do is, like, let's look at, where's my TCM at? Next page, it looks like. Engine, transmission. So we have two different ones.
Yeah, it's not the mechatronic.
It's not this one, so no. It's this one.
Yes.
So we have, and the pins we were on were 34 and 46, correct?
Correct.
Okay, and then those are all going to be tied in here. Everything that is being highlighted, all of these together. See, that kind of sucks for me in within this network. Like, everything that's on here. So this, let's see, orange. So 4 and 2. Two goes in there, four goes in there. That's, and then our, we're talking on these lines. This line and this line go to the data link connector. And the lines we're seeing all that crap on is this line and this line. So there's
so we're not gonna see it.
We're
not gonna see it at the data link connector.
I don't think so. I mean, what I would like to see is these two lines being tied into the rest of the network, and they're not. They're going to this gateway. I don't know what else. Guys, we're kind of debating. The reason why we both now believe that this signal was not seen at the data link connector with my special tool.
Yeah.
The special tool is these lines do not go directly to pin 6 and 14. Sorry. These pin 6 and pin 14 on the data link connector do not wire in directly to the CAN network. They are the CAN network, but they go to this.
From the data link connector.
What do we call it again? The gateway?
Yeah.
The gateway. We were still able to measure the resistance of the CAN network through it, so somehow they're connected, but
yeah.
Signals look weird. I'm sure that that same signal is messed up throughout the network in other modules. Is there another one that we can get to easily?
Maybe.
I could probably tell you on my diagram easier.
Yeah.
Maybe at this point, Tommy, the next thing we should do is look at the flow chart and just see what else we can do. I don't, you know, want to get lost on this network when I don't think that it's really necessary. Engine control module, transmission, power steering, electromechanical power steering motor above the steering rack subframe.
That's on there?
Yeah.
That connector is right here.
Is it?
Yeah.
Let's look at
that. We can access that.
Let's do that real quick. All right.
I don't know why I know that. I just know.
Because you're cool.
It's just one of those things. You just know.
No, top right
here. It's this little two-pin
connector.
Oh, sweet. It's right there. So you can see our CAN lines right there.
Yeah.
There's another, there's three there, but whatever.
How do you feel about back probing that? You okay with it?
I love it.
Okay, before we jump onto that other module, I just want to show you this again. Watch this, Tommy. I get no signals on this at all, which is kind of crazy. But if I would go to my scan tool, and then I want to do this a little different than reading codes this time. What I want to do is, if I go to my, where's my engine, Tommy? It'll be engine management.
Top one. If we do like a bi-directional.
I just want to go to the data.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Just no, go to sense. Live data, and then what we should have while this is communicating, we should now have signals.
Makes sense.
So the only time you're going to see his signals on 6 and 14 on the data link connector is when the scan tool is talking to, look at how that signals. You see that, Tommy? Look how it's like, I don't know if I was missing something or not. Oh. To finish that thought, the only time you're going to see signals here is when you're talking to the...
That makes sense.
Yeah. So now we're, I guess, could we say now that this is talking to that, are we now connected to everything else? I don't know for sure. But doesn't it look like the signals are actually growing? Like, see how the amplitude of that is changing? Where's my vertical cursor when you need it? Or is that just the pulse width
that's
changing?
That's what it looks like.
It's not, I mean, the, it's not the up, down.
It might be. No, the up, down is changing.
It is changing. Like the height. Yeah.
No, you can. I can see it on scale over
yeah,
here.
Yeah, let's see if the camera's picking that up. Disconnect that TCM, Tommy, while I'm watching that. Still doing it?
Yeah.
Okay. So characteristic, could we call it? More network stuff. Mirror image, CAN network. Go ahead, plug it up.
Strange. Unfamiliar.
We'll get there. The more we mess around with these, the more variables we'll see, and it's, you know, this is what it takes, right?
Here's what I'm, my question.
Yeah.
Using this,
yeah.
Okay, this really, does this tool help us? The only way that this really would help us, you know, like this is just scan tool talking to gateway.
Right.
So when would we use this if we don't have communication to the gateway?
I don't know. Well, on this particular car, I don't know that I can answer that. They're not all wired this way.
Right.
A lot of them, if you look at the CAN networks, I know this for sure, that the rest of the lines that are going to all the other modules are directly wired to the data link connector. On this particular car, it's not.
No.
The only thing going to the data link connector is the gateway. So there's variables. It's a variable.
Yeah.
Does that make this tool a little bit less useful? Maybe on this particular car, but I don't know. I mean,
I was just wondering, you know, when would this tool ever help us?
I am positive that this tool is going to help us with some of these down the road. And I mean, you see the convenience of it, you know, with...
Oh, yeah, no.
Yeah, I'm with you here.
It may just be the system.
No, I'm with you here, and I'm actually glad we had this connected because we wouldn't have known this otherwise.
Right.
So if you want to talk about a tool helping us right now, well, we're starting to learn a little bit about more about the network. So,
yeah.
Okay, flowchart. To be honest with you, Tommy, I don't know. I wouldn't know what else to do in this particular circumstance. I'm with you on what you think this car needs, which is a TCM.
Yeah.
What other tests can we do to prove it? Now we're gonna go to that other. Just to see what it looks like there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that'll be helpful. And then we'll look at the flowchart and we'll make the call. And
I mean, we know that the TCM is putting that.
Hash,
that characteristic,
yes.
Yeah,
it's changing,
putting, yeah,
absolutely.
We know that it's coming from that. We know that that's not right. It should not be doing that.
Right. So, you know, back to this tool for a second. My question is, we have those termination resistors. They clearly were being measured, which is through the network, but yet we're only connected to the gateway, and I'm not seeing those same signals on the rest of the network unless these are talking. You follow my question? Kind of is like, how do we measure the 60 ohms? I guess is my question.
Yeah.
How do we measure the 60?
If it's not tied into that.
Because it is tied into that. But is it only tied into it now? And let's leave the scan tool talking, and let's back probe this guy up here and see if we can ask that question again.
Yeah.
Oh, dude. We need to get my test drive VERUS leads. Hold on. Be right back. Check these out.
Those are
another new toy. These are test drive leads. I always complain about how short these stupid leads are.
Yeah, dude, the black and yellow,
it's trash.
Hey, dude, where are we at?
We are back probing the same network at a different location.
So we need two different channels? Yes?
Yes.
Look how long these are.
Nice. It's awesome.
That's
so nice.
Wait, that's me. Which end's you? Wait, what?
This, that one.
It's got doubles on both ends.
Does it?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Ah, that makes sense.
Yes, it does.
The ground.
Yes, duh. Here, and then that's...
That one's you.
This side's
this
you.
This side's me.
These leads are awesome. Look, we don't have to move the tool. We can just bounce back and forth. Yeah, there's our poopy looking signal back.
Yeah. We don't have a ground. Do we?
No, we need one.
What if we? Yeah. What if you just plug that?
Yeah, yeah. Can I reach?
Just take. Oh, we changed our voltage a little bit, right?
We did.
Okay.
So, crazy part about this.
Change those a little bit. Well,
look at the.
You can see it already.
That's the CAN lines at, again, this is at the what?
It's for the power steering control module.
Okay. And then, it'd be nice to have all of this in there. Let's do that. Let's go three and four. Will we need another ground? No, we shouldn't. Because the tool has a ground. The tool has a ground.
Okay.
So just go three and four. Let's turn all four. Now, this we might not have enough. We can't do. It doesn't have the bandwidth.
I bet the Pico does.
It does. What's wrong? Nothing. Just the other two are talking differently because let's move these around. Are we still communicating with the scan tool? Yes, we are. Where are those signals? Is it maybe they're there, but like this doesn't have enough? We're kind of aliasing with these other channels on, so we're not picking it up. Pico.
You think it's an issue with the scope?
I don't know. I'm reading the flatline 2.5 volts. It's probably communication here, Tommy. That shouldn't matter because all the channels are. Let me try something here. Remember, this isn't going to talk to us unless things are happening. So let's go back into data again.
What?
Why can't I look at, there it is. It's just not talking frequently enough.
Yeah.
On that line. It was clean looking up there compared to down here though. If I could get the, if I go to a functional test to make it do stuff.
Yeah.
So do, which one?
Do an actuator test. And it might only give us 30 seconds.
But so it'll go
that'll
through,
be,
it'll,
yeah,
it'll
that'll
go
be
through
enough.
A sequence.
That'll be enough for us to
yeah.
pause it and look at, there you go, so.
Okay. I would think that we would have a lot more
communication signals on here. Why don't we, Tommy?
What the hell? What if we put the trigger on one of these ones?
Duh. That's exactly.
Oh, there was.
That's exactly what it is. They're not. They're just not a.
If you
smart man, this young man over here is. Duh. That's what I need to do. I need to pause it, zoom out. We'll have all of our signals here. Now they're just not occurring at the same time.
Yeah.
I guess I just assumed that we would have more there, and we would be. You're totally right.
There we go.
Obviously, the packets of data are a lot more. It's just crazy to me that we wouldn't. I mean, look at the difference in the signals themselves. These are the two, the blue and the red, would be going right to the gateway.
Gateway, yeah.
On pin 6 and 14, and then these are the crappy looking signals on the rest of the network. I don't know why I'm not seeing those same signals on 6 and 14. I don't know enough about the gateway to know. It's just saying, no, I'm not giving you those signals. You don't need them. I'm only giving you what you need.
Yeah.
That's what it seems like to me. But clearly this network's being screwed up. This is, guys, to be clear, the bottom two pictures, the green and the yellow, that's our CAN network. So is this, but this is the actual network itself. Now, I know one thing for sure, Tommy. We don't want to unplug the TCM while this is in a bidirectional mode. I think that I'll draw the line there. What do you think?
I would agree.
Yeah. So let's stop talking to that. This is now live. Again, look how clean these signals are. And these ones are, again, going straight to the gateway. These ones are directly on the network. And we're connected to what, power steering motor?
Steering electric control module, because it's electronic steering, so okay. It needs a module.
So it's part of the network. Messed up signals for sure. We unfreeze that. We can look at these live, and then let's unplug this TCM again and see what that signal looks like.
Okay.
Yeah, look how clean that looks. As soon as you unplugged it, the both lines actually increased too. That's a beautiful looking signal. I don't know. Here's what we know for sure. It's not a wiring problem in between. In other words, if it was like high resistance or something and only affecting this one leg of the circuit where we measured before, we would have had a clean signal. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
We would have had a clean signal up at this power steering module.
And
not down at the TCM. The fact that we have a messed up signal up top makes me want to measure the resistance on the network elsewhere, because I can't measure. I just feel, I mean, we did read 60 ohms, but I feel like,
yeah.
Let's look at the flow chart.
Yep.
All right, good.
All right, so this is the CAN bus terminal resistance transmission control module to engine control module checking. But I don't know if that matters, if it says it goes to the ECM. I mean, there's a bunch of stuff on this network.
So is that the only NOCOM flowchart we have, though?
This
terminal resistance.
This was for that fault, the U transmission, no communication. This was specific.
Gotcha.
And it makes sense, because where were we getting that fault code? From the ECM.
Okay, gotcha. So this was the ECM flowchart, ECM fault code flowchart, yes, for NOCOM to the TCM.
Correct.
Got it. Cool.
All right. Test requirement. CAN bus malfunction recognized. We know that. Fuses are okay. We know that. I mean, this is all like, you know, preliminary stuff.
Yeah, read it to us. I mean, because we're not going to be able to see it. It says lights switched off.
Yeah. Battery voltage at least 12.5. All electrical consumers, lights, rear window defroster switched off. Vehicles with auto trans, shift select lever in park or neutral, AC off. Ground connections okay between the engine, transmission, chassis, and ignition switched off.
Okay.
Function. The ECM J623 communicates with other CAN bus capable control modules. The control modules are connected by two data bus wires, which are twisted together, CAN high and CAN low, and exchange information messages. Missing information on the CAN bus is recognized as a malfunction by the ECM J623 and the other control modules connected to the CAN bus. Trouble-free operation of the CAN bus requires that it have a terminal resistance. This central terminal resistance is located in the ECM.
Okay, cool. That's good information. That's what we checked. Although we thought we were checking it from 6 and 14. I'm not so sure, but yeah. Go ahead.
Test procedure, perform a preliminary check to verify the customer's complaint.
Yep.
We know that.
Yeah.
Start diagnosis, disconnect the transmission control module.
So the start of our diagnosis is disconnect the TCM. Got it.
The ECM must remain connected for the following step.
Okay.
Use a multimeter to check the TCM electrical harness connector terminals 34 to 46 for resistance, specified value 60 to 72 ohms at 20 degrees Celsius.
Okay, and that's the two terminals.
The two pins going to the TCM?
That's the, isn't that the ones that we were back probing? 34 to 46?
Yeah.
So we should.
So, but here's what it's saying is it's telling us to the first thing was to unplug the TCM.
Unplug the TCM. So the reason you're doing that measurement, it's not a measurement of the TCM, it's a measurement of the network. Heart.
Yes. Okay, that makes sense.
So, but they're not having us do it, interestingly enough, they're not having us do it at 6 and 14.
Right.
They're having us do it
at the TCM.
At the TCM. That makes sense now that where we are with everything.
Okay.
We should redo that check, but let's keep going. Other than that,
If specified value was obtained, check the TCM powers and grounds at the module.
Yep.
Refer to the wiring diagram. If power and ground is lost, the TCM will not communicate. Correct any power and ground fault before replacing the component.
That's it. Measure resistance, check your power, check your ground, done. Change the TCM. That's all we got.
Yeah.
And if resistance is not okay, then we're going to be attacking wiring here. That's what this is. The rest of this then would be, if resistance is off, the rest of this flowchart is fix your wiring problem.
Correct.
Let's do the resistance measurement at the TCM, and then we're done.
Makes sense.
Yeah, yeah.
I was hoping it would give us, well, that terminating resistor is in the ECM.
There's two of them, Tommy.
Okay.
Two of them. Terminating resistors, 120 and 120, that are 60 ohms.
I'm not good at math, but that makes sense. If you have two, cuts it in half.
That's right.
My math problem.
Yes.
Makes sense.
60.
Totally makes sense.
120, 120, divide them in half. All right, Tommy, tell me what we're doing.
Okay, right now we are going to do our resistance check. We're going to disconnect the TCM, which we already have that disconnected.
Yep.
And we're going to check our network resistance from the TCM out to the network, which makes more sense. So we're going to do our check that we did at pin, 14 and 6? Mm-hmm. We're going to do that at the TCM and check the network from the TCM. That makes more sense. Key off, right?
I think the key's still on. You need to shut that key off.
So there were.
Yeah. We need.
In the flow chart, it said to do some things.
Did it say to have the?
No. Well, I think in the first check it said ignition switched off.
Okay. I'm on the wrong part. Okay.
They're not going to tell us how to plug it with it on.
You know what's cool though? Like for you guys that are watching this and be like, man, you should have disconnected the battery. It just says disconnect the TCM. It doesn't even say turn the key off.
Yeah.
It really doesn't. It doesn't even say to turn the key off. No, granted we did, but anyway.
Because we're cool.
And we noticed too when we had the key left in the ignition that we were getting about 0.8 of a volt on the network. So we pulled the key out. The key is out.
All right. So I'll just back probe.
Yep.
It's at 46 and 34.
I'll hold the meter so.
It's the only orange wires. What was our spec?
61 ohms. 61.5. That is different than we had at pin at 6 and 14. Yeah. 6 and 14, we had what? 66 ohms? See, I wonder how valid that test is at pin 6 and 14.
For this car?
I don't know.
Yes.
I don't. Yeah, variables, sure. Guys. Variables. We would love to hear your thoughts on this particular test as far as the network goes. Just want to remind you guys that pin 6 and 14 goes to the gateway module. It does not plug. They're not directly into the CAN network, even though they're CAN lines. We did have a different resistance number, but what this tells us is what, Tommy? What does the 61 ohms tell us?
This would tell us that our network's good and we need a TCM.
Yep.
There's, after I already checked the powers and grounds. Powers and grounds are good.
Right.
That would have been the next step.
Yep.
If I didn't already do that.
Okay.
But it's good.
So what you need to do then, Tommy, because I'm not coming back for the TCM replacement. Tommy is here. What Tommy's going to do, what you're going to do, I'm kind of telling you guys.
What I'm going to do.
Is when you change this TCM, how about filming it for us? And then just get us the signals again on the VERUS, just on what they look like, you know, with it plugged in.
Yeah.
Just same thing you did already. And then just make sure that we can communicate with it and that our codes are gone and it comes out of park. So,
yeah.
And then we'll update that. Then I won't have to come back. Tommy will get me that footage. We'll put it at the end of this video and make the call. Pretty difficult diagnosis, I think, from a standpoint of you know, just being sure. Is there something we missed? It almost feels like there is, but this is what we have. We're using a manufacturer flowchart, and we have a network issue where the TCM's not talking.
It was actually pretty
straight.
Pretty simple.
It was very simple. We did complicate it. You guys that are watching this, there's a reason we're complicating it, because what Tommy and I are trying to do is go beyond the flowchart and understand how this system is actually working. Part of research, and we're learning, and this is something we won't forget about pin 6 and 14, you know?
Yeah.
There's a variable to that. We read a different resistance. It wasn't much different. What would be nice is down the road having a shorted, I don't want to do it to this car. This is a customer's car.
Yeah.
A car we can play with. Let's short like can negative at the we're not going to do it, but just short can negative at the TCM and then measure pin 6 and 14 resistance and see if we see a change. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
We're not going to do that because I don't know if I'd hurt.
Use your truck.
I don't know if I'd hurt something. We use my
truck. Use your truck.
For more experimentation down the road. But guys, listen, you need to follow this guy. This is my VW Master Tech. Tommy and I are going to do some more videos together. Give him some love on his channel. You guys that wanted more European cars, this is the guy. How many videos you got up now? 20 or so?
Maybe 30.
30 videos, man. Give him some love. He needs your support. He's working here full time, and to be able to have my former student who is now doing this, who's a master tech, and then he's also now doing YouTube videos, is freaking awesome. I love to see it. I'm excited to see you doing this, Tommy. And when you guys hear this guy talk, it's funny. I've had these comments where you guys are like, oh man, you sound like ScannerDanner. I was his teacher, so that kind of makes sense. These fundamentals that I'm always telling you guys about that I'm teaching.
I'm okay with it.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the only comments I get. Dude, you sound just like Danner. I saw the tattoos. I was like, what?
I know. Okay, so listen. You will find him, again, this is Positive Lead Diagnostics. I will put a link in the description of this video to find his channel. And if you like what I'm doing, man, make sure you click on subscribe and like, and go to my Facebook page, ScannerDanner, go to his Facebook page, Positive Lead Diagnostics, like us on Facebook. You'll be able to see what we're doing. When we upload videos, that immediately goes to Facebook. It's a message. And there's other things we do on Facebook too. But the other thing too, my website is ScannerDanner.com for you guys that want to be part of an online forum and community. Tommy's on there too. Make sure you go to my website, go to my forum. If you have any questions that maybe are not being answered on YouTube, go to my forum and sign up for that. It is free. There is no cost for the forum. And I guess that's it. Is there anything else? Of course, I got to plug ScannerDanner Premium, which is my college course. I teach at a technical college, and I have a paid channel where I kind of invite you into my classroom and really give you the training that I gave Tommy, you know, all these years ago. It's foundational type stuff. So for you guys that are interested more of automotive diagnostic training, check out ScannerDanner Premium right here on YouTube as well. So thank you so much, Tommy. I look forward to doing some more videos with you.
Absolutely.
Okay, cool, man. Thanks.